UFOs are no longer a joke.
Oh my gosh. They're all going against the wind. The wind's 120 knots to the west.
The phenomenon now being taken a lot more seriously because of videos like these that have been released. They're shot by U.S. Navy pilots encountering objects moving in ways they could not explain. The U.S. government says the videos are authentic, that it's investigating, and that it doesn't know what the objects are. Some of these authenticated videos have been leaked by filmmaker Jeremy Corbell.
The green one where it's like you see the night vision on the USS Russell, that was part of a much bigger UFO event series. So then I released the USS Omaha. You see the object dropping into the water.
What was splashed? Splashed. Mark bearing and range.
None of these craft have control surfaces, have wings, rotors, tails, plumes, or exhaust. None of them. None of them.
Well, if there's like another thing, it's rotating.
Are there actual like high quality 4K definition shots of these things that the military has?
Yes.
There is. Have you seen them?
I couldn't say.
Do you think we will ever see them as a public?
I hope so.
All this has led to a U.S. government intelligence report that will be released publicly. The New York Times this past week, though, leaked some of the information that's going to be in it. Apparently, the U.S. government looked at 120 incidents over 20 years and found them to be unexplainable. They could not definitively rule in or out that the phenomenon is alien spacecraft.
I have never claimed that these are aliens. I have never claimed that I know. What I am saying is that these are unknowns. And I'm not even saying it. Our military is saying it, that these are advanced aerospace transmedium vehicles that operate with impunity over our nuclear installations and restricted airspace, as well as other countries.
Indeed, there is a Canadian connection. Vice News published an article last week detailing the Canadian military's interaction with UFOs. Vice wrote it, quote, discovered close to 70 years of cases involving the Canadian Armed Forces, such as a large tubular object tracked by radar in 2002, a white spot turning blue and red and traveling in a zigzag formation above Ontario CFB Borden Base in 1978, and an orange pulsating symmetrical light witnessed silently speeding over Ottawa by a pair of Air Force officers in March of 1950.
Now, beyond what exactly these things are, the big question, I think, is what are their motivations? One thing that has been well documented throughout the years is that this phenomena tends to happen close to U.S. nuclear bases.
To this day, there are incursions by unknowns within our most restricted nuclear facility airspace. I can tell you that with absolute 100% certainty, and there is footage taken. Now, what are they doing? You know, look, your guess is as good as mine.
Corbell tells me he thinks the U.S. government may be more willing to discuss this type of information now because of an increase in public pressure to do so. The full U.S. Senate Intelligence Commission report on this phenomena is due out before the end of the month. In Toronto, Richard Southern, City News.